In our video today, we'll be looking at a custom no-code application built completely with ServiceNow's App Engine and Automation Engine. This is a lead-to-lease application, which is about lease management and administration for managing units and spaces within buildings and properties. Our demo takes us across three different users. The first is Davis, who is an office manager from Service Forever Private Limited, looking for a new space to move his company into. Davis loves a good application and tenant experience, and these are his top criteria in choosing a new space. Next up, we have, well, myself, Xiao. I'm the leasing manager at Now Properties, and I manage all aspects of unit and lease administration. So things like calculating occupancy, listing units for rental, and calculating lease and overage charges will be done by me. Before this app, I managed all of these through Excel, which was highly time consuming. Lastly, we have Beth, who is my finance manager here at Now Properties, and she takes care of the financial aspects of leasing operations. These are the critical activities like billing, invoicing, security deposits, and many more. The biggest time of a day spent before this custom app was in sending invoices, chasing collections, and doing double entries into the ERP system, which actually has no functionality to support lease management. There are six major sections to this demo. First, we will create a new property with a unit to be listed before Davis then goes ahead to apply for this unit. Back to us then to approve and convert this application into a lease and then hand it off to Beth to run the finances. You also get to see how the tenant portal can take care of all tenant related inquiries, and for this demo, we'll show you how Davis can request for a lease renewal through a chatbot. Let's take a look. We start off as myself in the property management workspace. As a leasing manager, I need to track different KPIs across my organization. The Tokyo release of ServiceNow introduced Dashboard Builder, which is what I use to build this dashboard that tracks the most important metrics for my role within leasing. I can easily add new widgets and edit existing ones as well. Heading into the list view, we see all the different data tables that were created in this custom app. For this demo, we'll be creating a new property, Horizon Towers. Notice how I included the building manager that references the sys_user table. As we build more applications that extends this data model, this will become highly useful, such as for facility maintenance requests or even emergency monitoring events. Once that's done, we'll create a new unit that lives within this property. The area here is recorded in square meters, which then get converted into square feet. This is important when we generate the tenancy agreement and invoices later on. Great! Now we have a new vacant unit created, we need a tenant to fill it. What we have is a leasing portal where prospective tenants can come and look for a unit to lease within our properties. Now let's make our newly created unit available on the portal. All units will automatically be synced to the unit listing table, and this is where we can choose to list these vacant units. You can see here the list of listed units, which is the same as what we just saw on the portal. If we switch over to the unlisted units list, we are able to see the unit 0888 that we just created. Clicking into the record, we now have the ability to add more details to the unit to be displayed on our portal. So let's go ahead and do that by adding a description, choosing the leasing agent who will be informed of any of these applications, as well as the rate per square meter. Remember, this is how we calculate the rental amounts. And then we will also add the main picture to the unit, and you can attach any supplementary pictures as well. Once we have all the necessary details, we'll click on List Unit, and this unit will then show up on our portal. Let's switch hats now and move into the roles of Davis, who now makes his way to our leasing portal. He sees the newly listed unit and decides to apply for it. On the form, you can see all the details that we entered, together with pictures of the unit that were added as well. There are all the necessary fields with validation, such as dates for the lease start as well as the number of months, and Davis then fills up all his particulars, and these will be used to contact and bill him later on as well. After filling the form and submitting, he will then see that the application has been received together with the reference number. Clicking on the record brings him to the request form, where he can communicate with the leasing agents as well as see the status of his application. So back to me as the leasing manager, I can then go ahead and approve his lease application once all the details have been verified. Note that we can build all the other related workflows such as background checks, unit requirements, tenancy permits, and more by extending this application, but we're keeping it simple for the demo today. After approving the application, we can head over to upcoming leases, and we see that the new lease will commence soon, together with all the details that we captured. we will change the lease start date to a month earlier so as to make this lease active, as you can see in the box being checked automatically. This will in turn occupy the leased unit as well. What happens next is the generation of the tenancy agreement for digital signing. First, we will click on the Generate Tenancy Agreement button, which will generate a PDF file of the tenancy agreement with all the details captured. To get Davis's signature, we will integrate the DocuSign as our e-signature solution. By clicking the DocuSign TA button, this will trigger the integration, sending the generated tenancy agreement to be signed. Now we are in Davis's email inbox, and you can almost immediately see the DocuSign document received. After verifying all details of the tenancy agreement, we will sign the document and finish. Back in the lease workspace, the signed copy of the tenancy agreement will be integrated and added to the lease record as we can see here, and this confirms service forever as an active lease on Now Properties, as we can see in the list here together with four other tenants. This also concludes the application process, and service forever is now a tenant of Now Properties, ready to move in and of course pay rent. And this brings us to Beth, our finance manager. She navigates to the rent roll table, and here we can see the previously run rent rolls. What she will now do is create a new rent roll for the month of January. A great feature that we have embedded in this application is Playbooks. Playbooks gives a guided experience to any user on processing a particular set of work. And what we've designed here is a step-by-step guide to help any user complete running a rent roll. This reduces any potential errors as well as training time needed for new staff. In this playbook, we will define the rental period and go next into the processing of the rental. Triggering this step, we see that the record gets updated with 5 leases as part of this rent roll, and in the related list, a summary of all these 5 lease invoices that will be sent to each tenant, including service forever. So let's drill into that particular rent line. Here we see the amount as per the lease agreement, and there is also GST that's automatically calculated, and the total will be billed to Davis. Back in our playbook, we will trigger the invoice workflow, which will kick off a few actions. The first is the generation of the invoice, then an integration to create an e-payment link with Stripe. Finally, Davis will receive an email from Now Properties that contains the generated rental invoice, as well as a link to pay that invoice. Clicking on the link, he'll be brought to a page with various payment options, but here we'll make a dummy transaction to pay off the invoice. Once done, this will trigger a final inbound integration from Stripe to ServiceNow, which will change the status of the rent line to collected. You can of course choose any other payment gateways as well. For the rest of the rent line invoices, let's go ahead and manually change their status to complete before marking our collection step in the playbook as complete, as this would trigger an integration of the transactions into Now Properties ERP system, which could be presented as an individual line item in a journal entry or just an entire trial balance as well. In the final part of this demo, we go back into Davis's shoes sometime in the future, where he loved leasing with Now Properties so much that he has decided to renew the lease. This is where he navigates to a central tenant portal available to all tenants to make this request. This portal can be used for all sorts of tenant services, for example, facility maintenance requests, booking of a common area, requesting for a lock change, and more through the service catalogue. Here we have quickly found the lease renewal request form, but to show you a different experience, let's make this request through Virtual Agent, the AI and natural language understanding powered chatbot on ServiceNow. We can see how Davis can interact seamlessly with the chatbot for this renewal request, and if at any point he needs to speak with an agent, he's able to do so. Back to the leasing workspace, we now see the lease renewal request. An approval email was also sent to the leasing and finance team, where they can approve it via a return email. This approval will finally create a renewal lease against Service Forever's tenant profile, and will automatically go into effect on the lease start date, cascading down to our rent rolls and billings from then on. This is where our demo journey will end, but I hope you see the endless possibilities and agility of building such an application on the ServiceNow platform. Everything you have seen today was built without using code in App Engine Studio. Let's have a quick look at the building blocks so that you can use some of this in your next custom app. Firstly, we have a leasing portal scope, and this stores the lease applications as well as where the leasing portal was designed via UI Builder. The single workflow here also contains the flow which converts a tenant lead to a lease once it is approved. The other property management scope here contains a few more artifacts, a number of tables here with the lease table being one of the main tables. you can see how we calculated the rental amounts using Formula Builder, which was in the Tokyo release of ServiceNow. This is also how we calculated the GST earlier on. A quick look at the overall data schema here. You can see how the different created tables are related to each other by either referencing or being referenced by one another. Moving to workflows, we have the email notification which sent the invoices to the tenants. The invoice PDF that was attached to the email, as well as the tenancy agreement, was generated via PDF forms. It's a free download on the ServiceNow Share site, which I highly recommend. Finally, integrations. Everything for DocuSign was done with out-of-the-box actions and all within a single flow as you see here, from sending the ad hoc signature request to Davis all the way to retrieving back the signed copy from DocuSign. The Stripe integration, on the other hand, was completely built from scratch without code. There are two main steps that happened in the backend. First, a customer record had to be created in Stripe, and this happens when a new tenant gets created. Drilling into the action step, you can see how this was a one-step REST call, which will use the customer's method to create a customer and return the customer ID to be stored against the tenant in ServiceNow. We can test this by creating a new record, and this will immediately get integrated into Stripe. After having this customer ID, we can then use the invoice method to create invoices against the tenant for the rent invoice which was emailed with the payment link for payment. That's all I have for this video. I hope you enjoyed it and helps you with your ServiceNow journey. Feel free to reach out to me if you want a copy of this application as well. Remember that this is only the beginning and the possibilities are limitless using creator workflows. No code, no problem.